Hi, I'm Colin Derdeyn from the University of Iowa and Stroke Council, and it's a great pleasure to be here today with Christian Stapf, who's now at in Montreal and one of the PIs of the ARUBA trial, which has been presented today. Christian, welcome.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. So what can you tell us about the long-term results of ARUBA?
Yeah. So ARUBA is a trial that was considering patients who had been diagnosed with a brain arterioles malformation, which is a relatively rare disease, but there, if you consider North America, there are 5,000 patients diagnosed every year. 3,000 are diagnosed with an AVM that has never caused the main complication, which is stroke, rupture, hemorrhage. And so in these patients, the ARUBA trial wanted to address the question whether preventive eradication of the malformation is the best way to prevent a stroke in such a patient, or whether it was safer to live with the AVM. Now, treating an AVM is complicated. Some are easily reached by surgical procedures, some require embolization, others are treated using radiotherapy, so it's quite a complex setting. But we compared the overall goal of taking the AVM away and the idea of living with the AVM. So ARUBA has been following these patients for nearly 5 years now. And the results to us are relatively clear. If you live with an AVM, you remain at risk of stroke roughly 2% per year overall. But if you try to take the AVM away, this risk increases by the factor 3 to 5 and makes it more likely to be handicapped related to the stroke or the intervention by the factor 2 to 3.
So the initial results of ARUBA that were published in New England Journal a few years ago now, though they showed in the medical arm, the conservative arm, the natural history group, about a 2% annual risk for rupture. And that risk has continued now for, is it a mean follow-up of 5 years, or is it 5 years in everybody? What was the length of follow-up in that group?
Length of follow-up average is between 4 and 5 years at the current stage.
Yeah.
The ARUBA trial had an interim analysis after less than 3 years of follow-up, and which has been published, was actually in The Lancet last year. And the concern was that the results have been published too early, not enough follow-up, too unstable results that may change over time. So it was important to look at the data now with more follow-up. And actually we were able now not only to see the overall results remain stable, but also to zoom into the various subgroups of AVMs. There are small AVMs, large AVMs, there are AVMs more at the surface, more in the depth of the brain, AVMs in eloquent zones of the brain, different grades. And the secondary analysis shown today showed that the effect favoring medical management without intervention remains robust across all subgroups. There's no benefit of treating small AVMs. There's no benefit in treating younger versus older patients. There's no benefit in whatever particular aspect of the AVMs you would look at.
Does the, so getting back to the two arms, so the 2% annual event rate has remained constant. In the intervention group, does all the morbidity and all of the endpoints, do they remain clustered around treatment? Or does that group that's undergone treatment, do they continue to have events in the long term? They continue?
Yes, that's a very important question. We have been looking in patients who have undergone treatment, what was the delay between treatment and an endpoint, which is stroke? And the median delay between an event after treatment was 1 day. which suggests that there is a strong relationship between the treatment intervention and the stroke that occurs following the intervention. The other issue that you alluded to is whether the curves will continue to climb up. This is the particular complexity of the trial because we have treatment modalities that have a single day event.
Yes.
Neurosurgery.
Yes.
So one intervention takes the AVM out. If you have a complication, it's going to be that same day.
Right.
Endovascular procedures, sometimes you need two or three.
Yes.
So the events, if any, may spread out over time.
Yes.
And then there's radiotherapy, which the day of the intervention has no effect at all, neither on the AVM nor on the patient, where the benefit but also the secondary, the serious adverse events may be long-term. And the mix of these effects may be an explanation why there is not a single jump mm-hmm. on day first, but
yes.
it spreads out over time longer than what you would expect considering a single intervention, a single disease with a one-day effect.
Are there enough patients in different treatment modalities to look at the relative benefit of for perhaps gamma knife radiation versus surgery or other
Absolutely.
Strategies?
That was one of the other very important questions raised by the interim results. Now we have enough data to look at any strategy used to treat these AVMs. And so as shown today, when you look at any embolization, any surgery, any radiotherapy, as monotherapy or as combined therapy, any type of intervention produces a significant amount of strokes.
Hmm.
There was not a single treatment modality that could be considered safe
yes.
or as the safe approach hmm. to AVM eradication.
Wow.
It was also to us a very unexpectedly robust outcome of the trial.
That's mm. important. Mm. You know, Aruba really is it's a great testament to you and your team to have organized and successfully executed this trial. It really remains unique in this disease as being the only randomized trial mm. data we have, and these mm. data are going to be extremely important for physicians taking care of these patients with these problems, and also for investigators going forward. And in that sense, what's the next yeah. study, and where do you go from here?
Yeah.
What are the questions?
Now, lessons learned from Aruba at this stage is that I think we don't have scientific reason to recommend preventive interventions in unruptured AVMs unless we test new hypotheses regarding specific AVM subgroups, maybe the very small ones, specific interventions, maybe surgery for the very small ones. That's one way to look at it. But I don't think we have reason to recommend treatment outside any new research protocol that would test such specific hypotheses. One of our neurosurgical colleagues, Dr. Michael Lawton from UCSF, is in preparations for such a surgical trial focusing only on the very superficial small AVMs, which could be the next step mm-hmm. to go.
Yes.
Another issue is, given the unexpectedly high complication rates for treatment, the question has been whether these interventions should also be tested in patients who actually had experienced stroke related mm-hmm. to the AVM. Mm-hmm. Do we have to compare interventional risk to natural history in ruptured AVMs? And one of the interventional colleagues at University of Montreal, Dr. Jean Raymond, is considering a trial that includes also the ruptured AVMs. These are pilots that are in preparation.
Yes, very good.
And it could be very interesting to find the next step. What is true is apparently we haven't been good enough so far, so we have to find a way to
to
be better.
Very sobering. Mm-hmm. Before I close up this discussion, any final words you'd like to add as far as the Aruba trial and future directions?
Yeah. The Aruba experience was very interesting for the sites participating, for the investigators. It fostered a lot of multidisciplinary research in many sites because it required a multidisciplinary team to participate. It created a lot of dynamics, and It is probably, if you compare it to other stroke prevention trials, the one that showed the biggest effect ever for stroke prevention in patients at risk, lowering the stroke risk by close to 80% if you don't touch a disease that is a risk factor for stroke.
Yeah.
And so medicine, as always, is a school of modesty. We learn by our misconceptions. I think Aruba is a call to find a way to be better in the future.
Wonderful. Well, again, congratulations to you and your team on such important work that's going to have such great impact on the care of patients around the world.
Thank you very much, Colin.
Yeah, thank you, Christian.